So socializing your puppy is super important, but it has to be proper, correct socialization. And there's often a problem with people sort of rushing up to your puppy and just grabbing onto your puppy or your dog, especially a rescue dog. Any dog that's new in your home or new to you especially requires bonding with you and some socialization, learn to trust you. But you have to make sure that people do not misuse your dog. So I'm going to show you a little bit what it looks like, give you a small example of what it can look like to have a person really come right up to a puppy. And then we're going to talk a little bit about proper socialization, which is super important.
What you doing? What you doing? What you doing, little puppy? What you doing? What you doing? What you doing? What you doing? How are you? How are you?
So we're gonna see from a puppy's perspective what a person looks like. And just bear in mind that I'm only about 5'1 and 3/4. And you know, like, you know, maybe 130 pounds, so I'm not a huge person as it is. And we're gonna use a standard-sized cockapoo puppy who is about 10 weeks old, so, you know, about the age that when you bring your puppy home. And you can see from his level what it looks like to have a person come over and really get down in their face, so.
Hi, hello. Hello, tiny puppy.
You can see what he looks like here. So we're gonna put the camera right at his face level. All right, buddy. This is what size he is. I see it. Down. And I just want you to hold the camera like right at his face as if the camera is like his eyes. See me? Yeah. And be like, oh, hi, look at the puppy. Hi, little puppy. How are you doing? Oh, I love puppies. I love puppies. You're so cute. Oh, I love you. He's not gonna tell me. Hi. Is that scary?
Yes.
Look at you. Hello, puppy.
Because I don't want it to be like just my boobs, you know?
Yeah.
You can see what it looks like when a person is near. You can angle it more up.
Look!
So you look kind of like a giant. That's even higher than his face. Can you lower it?
Yeah.
Yeah, lower a little lower. I'm gonna stay right there. The angle is like...
What a cute puppy!
Even that's lifting it up. Hold it right there.
Hi! I'm so much bigger than you! Hi, puppy! Hello! What a cute puppy! Wow! Hi, puppy!
Right? Could you imagine what that must be like?
Hi!
That puppy's already like... Like a monster, monster puppy. All right.
Oh, scary. So
not
scary.
Socializing, you're gonna go out with your puppy and everybody's gonna wanna pet your puppy because your puppy is adorable and I want your puppy to get out and about. Take your puppy to dog-friendly stores, stuff like that. No dog parks though until your puppy's done with his or her shots, and no pet stores that sell puppies or have rescue puppies, and no rescue centers. You get out there, say you're in Home Depot or you're in like a Tractor Supply store or PetSmart, you're going to notice that there are gonna be people that are gonna come over and they're gonna wanna touch your puppy. And even as your dog grows up, you're gonna have people that wanna come over and touch your dog. I don't know what it is, but there are people out there that sort of feel like all dogs are like public dogs or something. You have to make sure that you are not going to be so nice to other people that you're allowing your puppy to kind of get misused. Your job is to establish this relationship with this little puppy that lets this little puppy know you're mama bear or you're papa bear. There's people that are huge to your puppy. I mean, consider how massive people must look to a puppy that is this big. They look huge and they come over and do all of the rudest things for dogs. It is not acceptable to lean over or touch the head. It's extremely, extremely aggressive. And so people not meaning to do the most aggressive things all the time to dogs. They get bitten for it, but they can also really cause fear and reactivity in your puppy if you allow it to happen. So if you know already that you're one of those people pleasers, I'm one of those people. So believe me, I understand the problem where you just want to be nice to everybody. Try really hard to just talk yourself up right from the get-go that when you go out in public with your puppy, people are going to respect your puppy's space. You don't know them. They don't get to touch your puppy. They can look at your puppy. They can talk sweet to your puppy. They can ask politely to pet your puppy. And then the answer is, either no, or you can ask the puppy. They put their hand out and the puppy smells their hand, then say that they can pet the puppy under the chin, on the neck, not on the top of the head, under here. Pet their chest, that's fine. But people will come over and just put their hand on that puppy's head and just rub it. Don't let people do that. And let your puppy see you protect him or her. So if you're walking and you're carrying your puppy and somebody comes rushing at you and tries to reach for your puppy, and you do this, your puppy is gonna be like, yeah, mom's got me. What you wanna do is have a dog that looks to you for protection, because otherwise your dog will protect herself. And you don't want her to do that, because that means growling or lunging or biting or snarling or something that is otherwise considered completely unacceptable in companion dogs. You want her to feel like if she looks at you, you've got this under control. Like, you are not gonna let anybody mess with her. And if she looks at you and she sees that you're submissive to every scary thing that comes over, then she's gonna think she has to protect you. You make sure that you establish right from the get-go that you are there to protect her from all the scary, scary things in the world. Because if you go out and something scares your puppy and mama's got it under control, they relax really quickly. And then you can continue to have really positive experiences. And then your puppy grows up to be a very confident, relaxed dog that can go anywhere and see anybody and doesn't have an issue with it. That is 10% genetics and like 90% correct socialization. And so correct socialization is not everybody and their mother should touch my puppy when my puppy's a puppy. It should be your puppy goes places and has really positive experiences everywhere they go. So your job is to look at your puppy and see what your puppy is doing. If your puppy's terrified and then they're somehow validated that their terror is correct, is warranted, like they're scared of a person, and then the person touches them, then they're gonna feel like, yeah, I was right to be scared of that person. See, if I hadn't run away, who knows what might have happened to me? If your puppy is terrified everywhere, it's not positive. It is not good socialization. What you're doing is teaching your puppy to be terrified. So what instead you wanna do is, if your puppy's terrified because a person comes over, but you block the person from having physical contact with your puppy, then maybe they can see the person talk sweet in a high-pitched voice, offer their hand for a sniff, you know, maybe pat them on the chest or under the chin where it's not so scary, and then walk away. Hey, that's awesome. You can also bring treats in like a Ziploc bag in your pocket. And if people come over and want to touch your puppy, but your puppy seems really just not comfortable just yet, what you can do instead is give them, like, I like bacon, because they really, really like bacon. And so even a nervous dog will usually take bacon. You can give them like a little tiny piece of bacon and say, here, you want to give her a treat? And then they can hold their palm out and offer the treat. That's awesome, because then your dog's like, ooh, strangers are fun. Socialization is definitely going to happen, but the key point of socialization is that your puppy is having lots of positive experiences. So you are the guardian. You are mama bear. Your puppy is a thinking, feeling creature. It is not a toy. And people have no right to come over and treat your dog like a toy. They may be very well-meaning, and I'm sure that most people really, really are. People should learn how to approach dogs. They should learn how to ask permission before touching people's dogs. They don't, and that's not your problem and it's not your dog's problem. So take it as a good opportunity to politely educate by saying, it's okay if you ask my dog, but if my dog's not comfortable, then you can't pet her. That's totally fine. And don't worry about it if the person thinks you're a jerk. So what? Strangers probably think I'm a jerk all the time. So as long as my dog thinks I'm awesome, I'm a happy camper. All right, well, I hope that was helpful and a good start for you understanding what it's like to be puppy-sized and to make sure that your puppy is socialized in a proper way that lets your puppy think that meeting new people is a ton of fun and that it's great to be out and about, and that way they never feel afraid if people approach them. They think, oh yay, a person, instead of thinking, oh my gosh, a giant that's gonna eat me. So keep that in mind and take good care of your puppies.